Okay. For the very first time. Oh, and welcome back. I'm gonna finish it this time. I only have a few more endings to go. Again, I'll be cutting out the redundant stuff, so if I don't show things here, then they're in a previous episode. Yes, please. Alright. I can't say I have any idea where this one's going. Mr. Nanaki demonstrates some extreme sleeping on the way home, but we arrived eventually.
Oh, this is very rustic, Kenya.
I like it this way.
It's wonderful. Have a place to come back to, isn't it? Wonderful indeed.
Oh, is that what your story arc's going to be about? You don't have a place to call home.
He looks a little sad. Sir.
See you tomorrow. Don't forget your homework.
And so he left. A somewhat hollow-sounding farewell echoing behind him.
Farewell, farewell.
Was it just imagination? Or was it just my imagination? Maybe.
Maybe.
Da-da. KAZUAKI. Da-da. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Good evening, Kenya. Such nice weather. Anyway, do you need something?
Sir, today's summer festival. Want to go together?
The two of us. I wouldn't mind, but wouldn't it be more fun with someone of your own age?
I think it'll be plenty of fun with you, sir. Let's go! And given you're a bird, I don't think any of you are really my age, but okay, unless you have, like, weirdly long lives for some reason.
This is the first time I've been to a festival here.
It's very lively.
I feel a little dizzy.
Are you okay, sir?
I'm fine, don't worry. I'm just not used to crowds. Ah, fireworks. Oh, nice. Have you studied redox color reactions, Kenya?
Oh, yes, in middle school. Copper turns green, sodium turns red, that sort of thing.
I gotta be honest, if I learned that in middle school, I don't remember learning it. No, sodium turns yellow, right?
Ah, that's right.
Teehee, silly me.
Anyway, that's how fireworks work. So beautiful.
I guess that makes sense, but okay. Though your eyes are even more beautiful, sir.
Damn it, he fell asleep.
He held up pretty well, but I guess he gets even sleepier than usual as soon as the sun goes down. And apparently fireworks aren't enough to keep him up. And besides, I think the girl's supposed to get told that she's prettier than the knight, not the man.
Oopsie-daisy.
Yeah. This is going to continue being weird.
You will? Ah, thank you. I'll go make some tea.
And so I spent the morning grading tests in the air-conditioned staff room like a proper little lady. Because apparently that's what students do, grade test. Oh, look, my test. I'm just gonna write a 1-0-0-0. That's fine. His tea is very good.
It has mango in it. I do like my tea sweet.
Okay. Was that really the only thing I had to do there?
No.
Okay. So many things to do, I can't choose.
Oh, Kenya.
Mr. Nanaki, what is it?
Your shift is tomorrow, right?
Yep.
Could you maybe help at the reception desk? We're getting a lot more people than we expected.
Of course, I shall mete out information and directions like an oni of old, cleaver in hand, steeped atop a throne brought in skulls my foes.
I know what an oni is, too. I actually know.
Thank you. I'll go get a chair.
Okay, it's probably just because I played Orishika back when.
Looks like the crowd's thinning out a little. That was tiring.
Are you okay, sir?
I'm fine, just a little. Well, at least he held up pretty well until now.
It's almost time to clear up and prepare for classes tomorrow. And so I spent the last hours of the festival nervously watching Mr. Nanaki sleep, slipping ever lower in his chair. They have chairs. See, I'm still not sure if I should take those things fucking seriously or not. The fact that they seem to be using human stuff at human scale and whatnot. So confusing. Ah! Hand at my recording, so my math... Oh, right. Hey, remember this. We're supposed to side with one side. Something. I have no idea what you're talking about anymore.
It's not very nice, Doctor.
What do you want? What is it? Sir, I gave you my recorder earlier instead of my homework. So you did. Here you go. Here's the workbook. Thank you, sir. Sorry, sir. I teach a high pupil. Say it was good. The true real life. I think I'll go home and spend some time fulfilling time. Spend some fulfilling time before going to bed. Is she saying what I think she's saying? Very fulfilling. Swallow. Oh, hi, Ryota. You know where Mr. Nanaki lives, right? Yes, but why would I know? Why do you ask? Left his phone in the staff room. He's already left, but you know how slowly he moves. If you hurry, you can catch up to him before he gets home. I could take it to him, but I need to run some errands for my mother before I go home. So I was wondering if maybe you could. No, get Okasan, he's so much faster. Sure, not doing anything. Thank you. Ah, welcome. Mr. Nanaka's phone, now that I think about it, I don't know anything about his personal life. Is he always as spacey as he is at school? I mean, if he's like really unprofessional and spacey in his professional life, I'm sure his personal life is so much better. He probably spends 97 blank blank of it, probably percent of his time at home asleep. A piece of paper fell out of the phone case. What's this? Ooh. It's a photo. A photo of a bird, but I can't see the face at all. Someone scribbled all over it. I wonder who. Did Mr. Nagi do this? It doesn't seem like him at all. I'll just put it back in the case. Maybe I should pretend I didn't see it. No, we have to... We can't, or else the plot won't go forward, sir. Hello, Kenya. Where are you going? Look like you're in a hurry. Sir, you forgot your cell phone. So I did. Thank you for coming after me with it, Genya. I should be you. No problem at all, sir. Was there something else? What should I do? What should I do? Guy, tell me. Ask about the photo. Sir, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to look inside, but something fell out. Fell out? The picture, I... yes, that. Don't worry about it. After all, it's not something you need to worry about, right? But I'm curious! It was almost completely marked out? Yeah, because I marked it out.
He did? I would never have believed it from someone else, but since it's him saying so...
Well, see you tomorrow.
Oh my goodness, my perception of the entire world just gone?
So we left with a farewell, as carefree as if we'd been just talking about the weather. He has a side to him I've never seen, doesn't he? He marked out a photo. Why is Swallow being insane at the moment? It's that time of year when the chill outside gradually breaks down my soul. Well, I'm done cleaning, so I guess it's time to go home. Where's my phone? I remember looking at a Daily Portal Z during the break, so... I can't have left it at home. We had a chemistry lab today, right? Maybe I left it in there. The door is open. Good. There it is. Have we used this background in any other situation here? Sitting right there on the bench I worked at. Sorry, were you lonely? Oh, no. Come on, let's head home. So I live in a...
I live in a cave, yet I have a cell phone. Clearly our priorities are well ahead of the curve. I bumped into... Doctor? Doctor, okay, this isn't gonna go well.
Oh, again, has your life no purpose aside from meddling with me?
No, I was even doing here. Came out of the chemistry prep room, right?
Alone, after school, in the lab. What were you doing?
I left something behind.
Did you see anything?
Eh?
I'm asking if you saw anything. What are you suggesting? Whatever could you be suggesting?
What is he talking about? Would it be a problem if I had seen something?
Very well. May I ask a favor of you, Miss Kenya?
Ah, yes, what is it?
Could you bring me the files from the prep room? The black ones?
On the desk? Isn't the prep room right here?
They are somewhat heavy for me, but I'm sure you will have no problem with them. Would you mind?
No, sir. I'm not sure I can get away. I can get away with saying no. I'll just do as he says. Dun 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 dun. Files. Which one's black, right? I don't see anything like what he asked me for. Wait. Door closed. I'm locked in.
Doctor, let me out. What are you doing? Let me out, brute, villain, fluffy heretic.
No reply. The building's going to be locked soon, and I didn't tell anyone I was coming here.
Somebody, help me. The doctor locked me in here. Help me. Why did he do that? There's no reason to unless he thinks I saw something I shouldn't have. This must be his way of shutting me up.
Or removing the evidence. That's probably it. I'm in
despair!
The evil doctor will probably be coming back with a cleaver or something that has left me in despair! Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm not sure I can make it out the window. But I have to get out of here, quickly. How can I? Footsteps. I could call someone. I have my cell phone. Coming closer. I have to hide. But there's nowhere to hide in here. I'm sorry, please.
How you doing in here, Kenya? School's closed already.
Mr. Nanaki?
I heard noises coming from over here. Were you banging at the door, Kenya? That's not good. The door isn't a punching bag.
I think I can see a halo around his head. I can practically hear angels.
I'm alive!
Yeah. Sir, I... There's some dangerous things in here, so...
Don't come in without asking, okay?
I didn't come in on my own accord. The doctor!
That's right. I asked it to.
You're admitting it.
You did. Indeed, I am... truly sorry. I completely forgot I'd asked her to get something and locked her in and walked off.
You locked the door as soon as I walked in here. What are you, Clive, wearing?
Is that it? Okay.
This whole thing stinks of ill doing, Mr. Nanaki.
The doctor said it was an accident. I think it might be best if you went home as soon as possible this time of year, Kenya. It gets dark so quickly.
That is true. I wanted to leave early, but then all this happened. Well then, I'm at home now.
Stay safe. I have a career plan survey tomorrow, so don't forget the printout from earlier today. Kenya is a very honest, nice girl, isn't she? Oh, she is a little bit restless.
I agree completely. Anyway, I shall excuse myself for now. Goodbye.
Doctor?
Yes?
That was a little sloppy. You failed to pay sufficient attention to your surroundings. That sort of thing would be the death of you, you know?
Just kidding. Accidents like that happen to everyone. And you remember to come let her out in the end. Don't worry about it.
Yes. Thank you, Professor. I'm a high school teacher. Pretty sure we're not professors. But okay. Whatever.
So, Mr. Nanaki.
Hello, Kenya. What is it?
Today's Legmentines. I want to give you these beans.
You want to give them to me?
That seems like a pretty inappropriate relationship between a student and teacher, don't you?
I mean, yeah. Are you sure that's okay? You don't have someone else?
No, sir, I wanted to give them to you, sir. I don't know what kind of things you like to eat, sir, so I wasn't sure which you get, sir, but, sir.
Ah, millet seeds. I like them very much. I've enjoyed them for a long time. They bring back good memories. Such a nice, gentle smell.
Sir, they do smell nice, sir, but please don't fall asleep, sir.
Oh, are you really sure you want to give these to me?
Yes, sir, hunter-gatherer never goes back on her word, sir.
Thank you, then. I wonder what I should give you in exchange. I'll have to think about it.
And so he wandered off towards the staff room, a gentle smile on his face. Birds can have a smile. I'm glad he liked them. Okay. Only one thing I need to do.
Hello, Kenya. Asking to meet outside is a little odd. If it's about your career plan, don't worry. You're still a sophomore. You don't have to decide for a few months yet.
No, sir, I wanted to ask you something.
Oh, please do.
Sir. I like you, sir. Is that all right, sir?
You say the strangest things, Kenya. I like you too, ma'am. Kind, smart, you work hard.
But I didn't mean it like that, sir.
Listen, I'm no longer able to love another creature. It's not your fault, Kenya. I'm sorry.
No longer able to love another creature? What does he mean?
You saw it, remember?
Saw what, sir?
A photo.
Yes, sir, I didn't mean to, sir.
Don't worry about it. I know you wouldn't lie. I suppose I should tell you. That was a photo of the most important bird in my life.
I'm sorry, sir. I didn't mean to come in between, sir.
Thought we could live through anything, just the two of us. I think we meant more to each other than any birdie else in the world. But one day I looked around, I was alone. Life changed. After that, I stopped caring about a lot of things. I can never forget. Never forget our life, our promises. But I'm not sure how to say this.
As I looked at the photo every day, I realized I couldn't tell anymore.
Couldn't tell. Couldn't tell if I felt love when I saw that face, or if I felt hatred.
I think losing someone dear is painful for everyone, sir.
After a while, I couldn't stand to see it anymore.
So you, sir?
That's right. Even as I tried to forget, some part of me didn't want to. You see now, right? Well, I don't want to love again. By now, the love I felt has soured into resentment. Rather than forcing all the hatred onto one person, I think it's better to love everyone around you just enough that you won't regret losing them.
That's, sir, too sad, sir.
Don't you agree, Kenya?
I love your kindness, sir. But when I see that kindness bring you pain, sir, I have to wonder. There isn't a better way, sir.
I wonder. Either way, there's one more thing I should tell you.
Hmm?
That photo,
It's gone now. I burned it.
Huh?
When you saw it, it made me think about things again. I never would have shown it to anyone, so I was rather shaken. We both know that one of us would be gone one day, and neither of us would have wanted the other to mourn. So as I looked at the photo, I thought it was better. Better to put it away. So I burned it. Sort of. As an apology for defacing it like that. I should remember the beautiful face I knew, not a photo covered in scribbles. Oh, sir. Yeah, just because I'm a teacher doesn't mean you should always look up to me.
That doesn't have anything to do with it, sir. But, sir, I understand that you don't want to forget her, sir.
I have an idea, Kenya. I will be waiting here at this school forever. If after you've grown up a little and you still feel the same way, I'll be here for you.
Sir, that's...
I don't like to make idle promises, but I'm sure you'll grow up into a wonderful person, Kenya. So, let's wait until then.
Yes, sir. Graduating, growing up, and then coming back here. That'll be another story.
Sequel.
I don't know what he'll say to me on that day, but I don't know what I will feel or what he will feel, but right now, I'm truly happy.
Is that really? Oh my goodness, that was like really not good. I mean, the pain of loss is one thing, and logically, it actually might be the most sensible down-to-earth one there was, but there wasn't much of that story, I guess, when you get down to it. This is my opinion. I mean, I guess it's better than the Okusan ones, which, as ridiculous as those were, made no fucking sense, and apparently those were author inserts of the author's birds, and it's just like, okay. I suppose that makes enough sense, explains why that was a thing in the first place at all, period. Just, oh my goodness, sometimes. No, this one, I think? Underground facility fire. We've temporarily opened the dividing wall in the underground facility at the request of the Biological Science Division. We should be able to reconstruct the circumstances of the fire. Subject 00 remains in cold storage. I wonder if these, I wonder if the numbers to these mean anything. No, probably not. Then again, it might be. Okay, the death of Subject 00's relative has been confirmed. So, I sort of got a feeling that this was referring to Yuya. Considering the fact that the doctor's supposed to be part of that one bird party. And where's Subject 00 supposed to be Sakuya? Not that he seems remotely special, but it would make some semblance of sense in terms of parts of these. Well, if everything gets answered later, I should only have a couple more endings. Okay. Mad love of a fallen angel. Oh, okay. Stuff is happening. Stuff was happening. New stuff. I didn't recognize it as new stuff. Hello, person. I turn around and see that. Oh, I should mention. I did in fact see the thing in this guide that has the picture of the character, and does say below it, it's a big dumb RPG reference for fun. And I was curious going into this if I'd recognize what it's referencing. At the moment, definitely not.
You are the one who called forth this disaster, the one who invoked the broadcast of the blue sky.
I have no idea.
The blood. You're bleeding.
My chest, you are.
Ryota, I don't think you understand Japanese. You have to get him to the infirmary.
Oh, don't worry, look closely. He isn't hurt at all.
What? But the blood?
No, he's all luxin' from the class next door. Their plumage just looks like that.
Wait, really?
Correct. I am Hickory, Angel, the fallen servant of God, is stained with the blood of sin.
So he's 8th grade syndrome?
This impressively opposed to bird is Hickory Angel.
Angel.
He's in the class next to ours, so he must be another sophomore. That is an odd name. I wonder if he came from overseas like Sakura. His Japanese is kind of strange, too. Everyone introduces themselves. The corruption spreads faster than I expected. I'd hoped to find it before I came this far. Sleeping servants of the heavens.
Yeah? I mean, he's talking to me, right?
Time is slipping by. Judgment draws ever near. You must find the truth by the light of the red moon. A little longer. Be silent, Crimson Beast.
You are hurt, aren't you?
Do not touch me. Farewell. It's a blue, blue sky. Fate decrees that we... We shall meet again.
And he's gone. What was that all about? I think you've picked up a weird one, Swallow. Well, let's go eat lunch. Weird indeed. Oh, okay, it went into something else. I was arguing with Sakuya about the heat.
Red Eye of the Demon led me here. You summoned me once more, Apostle of the Blue Sky.
Him again. Okay.
Who is this?
I think his name Angel. He's the class eccentric next door.
Another peasant. None of you have the right to even be in this school. Go back to the Philippines and bang some coconuts together, why don't you?
Why the Philippines?
Luxon bleeding hearts?
Luxon bleeding hearts are from the Philippines? Ah, well, I guess that's why they're called Luxon. Luzon bleeding hearts? The Philippines have bananas, right? Now I want to call him Banana Man. I'm just going to call him Banana Man. Incidentally, Sakuya is about as unhinged as Banana Man, so maybe they could be friends.
I have no business with you, Hallowed Magician of White. Apostle, the Blue Sky.
Yeah.
Can you not remember who I am?
It says to say a fallen angel.
Could you be
a fallen angel escaped from the demonic prison of Judica?
Have you woken at last, Apostle Adel Blau? We have but little time left, you must decide. Will you cross swords with me on the promised ground or? No, not now.
Angel? He flies away into the corridor in spite of my protest. What a busy bird. Okay. Hello, Angel. He appears like a crimson star descending from the heavens, breaking everything, including all the glass around.
Metal Blau, the Blue Sky. I'm about to open a gate to the other world. What would you do?
A gate to the other world? You mean... He stares intently towards the end of the hallway. The infirmary.
The disguise is a Blau. I sense a powerful evil magic inside. No doubt the Tree of Blight's Rufa is taking root within. Left alone, it will swallow the entire school. We must stop it now.
I wonder how Dr. Yamine would react to an eccentric Filipino breaking down his door. He'd take out the oil and...
The time has not yet come.
The time's not yet come, Crimson Angel of Judica.
Is that true, Hedo Blau? Indeed, my demonic red eye feels no murderous aura. Perhaps it would be wiser to wait and observe for a while.
That's probably a good idea. Doctor doesn't take too kindly to roughhousing, I think. Okay, Angel leaves, satisfied.
Interesting.
The appointed time and place, but Angel's nowhere to be seen. He said he'd come, but is he going to stand me up anyways?
Oh,
this is the right time, isn't it? Is my phone's clock off?
How blow.
Maybe I should go ahead by myself.
How blow.
Meh. I can hear him, but where is he?
Angel, is that you?
I'm here. How blow.
A wild Angel appeared. Oh, you scared me.
Shh.
He frantically glances about.
Hello, demon of Baal. I can still feel its presence. It looks nearby, out of Blau.
Fighting evil again, are we, Angel?
You have but just awakened.
It is too soon to bring you into battle. Take this.
He hands me a charm. You could at least give me a sword or something if you really want to do whatever. If you really want to do this.
This will protect you from the forces of witchcraft, but we should leave this place nonetheless.
You're right. Come on, let's go to the festival. He's still as high strung as a violin. Maybe he's not used to crowds. This is your first time coming to a summer festival, Angel.
I was born beneath the star of solitude. I'm not allowed these pleasures.
Oh, don't tell me you don't have any friends.
Vescala of chaos. Why here? Why now?
He's staring agitatedly at a stand selling cheap toys and trinkets. Looks like a normal booth to me.
The chaotic wings of the Reaper appeared on this earth. The echoes of the end shall be heard across the land. Adoblau, you must undergo training.
It is so easy to lose track of your exercise regime during vacation. And so Angel and I enjoyed the festival in their own special little way. Okay. I picked up the ID card and apparently he showed up. Okay, what's going on, Angel?
You must not say a forbidden name. It shall open Pedro's gates and bring about the end of all things.
Apparently I said a forbidden name. This ID card's owner is going to cause the end of the world. And what's Pandora's Cage?
Angel?
Are you actually
See you to torture this servant of God? You must not speak the name of angels. You must not sing songs about the names of angels. You must not say it.
Perhaps my wish was not granted. Oh no, now he's sad.
Yoshio's a nice name. I mean, I don't really know what it, like, translates to or anything.
I know Japanese names tend to have a more direct meaning, but...
I shall accept the contract.
I will accept the contract offered to you, fool. I will tell him to. Accept the contract offered to you, fool.
What? You could not have forgotten it, Oblau. You were the angel of fire. You drove me from this world and imprisoned me into a cage of ice. Are you saying you will join me?
You are not alone, Angel.
Yes. Very well. We shall seal the contract on this ground, Oblau. Fleeting as it is eternal.
Angel scribbles some sort of indecipherable symbol or script onto the ID card and smiles happily.
It shall be proof of our alliance. Keep it with you.
Okay. He places his ID card in my hand and strides away. Might have to carry this around for you. Okay, whatever. Okay, something new's happening.
Yuya comes in and I say, asking for me, and are you finally being drawn in by my sexy and gradual style? Exactly, your beautiful lure stands out from afar, drawing me ever near. Like a guiding polaris, smelling Voodon.
But that's not what I came here to talk to you about.
Yuya lifts Angel up by the nape of his neck and holds him out towards me. What are you two doing here? Together.
Not fear at a blow. This man is not a foe.
What?
Well, I was going to clean up the infirmary and... the demonic blight grows strong with each passing day. When will the time come for action? Hey, you, what's up? You, by the fiend of darkness spawned from the pits of the abyss. Well, I might be a little bit of a creature of the night, but I wouldn't exactly call myself a fiend, no. My proper title would be the Midnight Rose. Or something like that. I see it now. In the past world, the Violet Rose, forgive my suspicions. Demons lurk behind every corner, friends. Apostle of the Violet Rose? Sounds like a dashing mask here in some shoujo manga. Suits me just fine. That aside, I advise you not to go in there. If you value your life, anyways. Warnings from those who follow the Violet Rose are heeded well by all but fools and dead men. Doctor works in here all nights at sometimes. His concentration is admirable, but it does take a toll on his patience. If somebody were to barge in while he was in the middle of something, well, let's just say it would be a pity if that mark on your chest got any larger, you know. Would the dark magician be so cruel? We must seal him away immediately. No, stop, I told you, man. Going in there is a suicide. And he kept trying to go in anyway, so I picked him up and hauled him away. Okay. I would call it okay, Yuya. But why you bring him to me? He said you were his friend. I thought it would be wise to report these discoveries to you at Oblau. Anyway, that's what that was all about. I'll let you take it from here. What do you mean, I do? Yuya, wait. I have to babysit Angel. Okay, well, let's go get lunch, Angel. I don't mind, but are you sure? Being seen with me may put your very soul at risk out of below. Whatever. Break is almost over, let's hurry. My goodness. Okay. He's weird. Manga Club here. Whenever they're doing a zine or something for the festival. I think I'll go take a look. Oh, I wonder who's going to be in the Manga Club. What seekest thou, Hellblow? Angel, are you a member of the Manga Club then? Indeed. This is my weapon. Angel produces a mapping pen with dramatic flourish. Well, it looks like it would get hurt. That looks like it would hurt you if it poked. It has stained many a day the gore of a friend and foe alike. Are you sure it's just not you're being careless and end up stabbing yourself a lot? Maybe on the chest? My scarlet precipitous. No, why now? Shall leave this you at a bow? I must go. In other words, it's your turn to run this to end and you want me to do it for you. Do what you must. Do what you must, Crimson Angel of Judica. I shall follow the covenant of my blood to the end. He nimbly leaps over a stack of books and runs off into the courtyard. It's not like I have anything better to do, so I'll just take shit for him. Lazy fuck. Here we go. Shh. Angel beckons to me. Completely visible despite his obvious attempts to conceal himself. Do you not sense the quickening, Edelblau? Quickening? The demon spores swarm with alarming intensity. They come from there. He's looking at. Still going on about the infirmary, huh? I've told you that it's merely a facade, Edelblau. Do you reply, Rufa? Yes, it is the incubator of absolute darkness.
Well, I don't totally disagree.
That makes even less sense. Why is a fallen angel stressing out over an infirmary anyways? The entire school will be swallowed by the demon spores. If we do not act, that to happen, my crimson beast would run wild once more. I might even... You?
I'm not sure why, but it seems like he's planning to hurt me. Scum, vagabond. Well, do you know that the Kenya family tradition is to kill first and ask questions later? I mean, we sort of failed at that in every opportunity, but okay. But the root of all evil, the Dark Sorcerer, is not here at the present. I must plan my attack. It's easy until then, that'll blow. Are we gonna kill the doctor? I don't mind, that's not bad. And with that, he returns to his classroom. He looks like a normal infirmary to me. Is something really going to happen? I don't know. I mean, maybe. I don't really think we're involved in it. There's nobody here. Oh, a bell from the angel inside a crucifix. Oh, a letter and a thing. Judgment draws near, says me, the promise plate, the crimson angel, Judica. If you're going to ask me out, can't you at least say when and where? Yeah, that's what guys tend to mess up the first time. Oh, he's here. You're holding out the line, he's upset, blah blah blah. Angel can decide which to get, and now he's hysterical. I'm gonna get my pay, Doc, for selling slowly. I need to get him out of the line, but looks like it has to be, looks like I get to be Angel's babysitter. Who could have known? What's wrong, Angel? Do you know the infinite possibilities of this universe that'll blow? Infinite possibilities, I mean. The present is but a single point in the vast cosmic supertime. Do I place myself under the protection of the wise knight, King Fisher, or the guiding pearl? I must decide which one most likely aid me in the... How about, traffic safety? You strike me as the type to fly out onto the road and get hit by a car, Angel. Traffic safety is good. Ryota, can you give us a traffic safety charm? Here you are. Thanks, Apollo. And so I paid for the amulet and dragged Angel out of the choked up line.
You lifted the burden of decision from my shoulders, El Blau.
Yep, don't worry about it.
Here's your amulet. Don't lose it. I thank you. Guide me well, oh wondrous pearl.
And so Angel took off into the trees, clutching his traffic safety amulet. I wonder if he'll remember to look both ways. He won't. Oh, I would find it absolutely hilarious if this ended with him dying by getting hit by a car like that.
Holy shit.
Today's the day. Preparations are complete. Time to give the beans to a special sunbirdie. I think he was in class two. Wonder if he's in the classroom. Apparently, I actually like him, despite the fact that he's only been annoying me. I hear. Yep. Hey, Angel, I have something to give you.
Wait, Herblau, we are in grave danger.
We are not. Angel pulls me from the room and runs into the hallway as if fleeing from something.
Stop calling me in that room, Herblau. For terrible evil. Hooks within? Well, not terrible, but still. There's a risk that I could be cursed if others were to learn of our connection.
Are you embarrassed to be with me? In other words, the other boys in your class will make fun of you for having a girlfriend. Okay, I guess we're at that level. Okay. Sorry, Angel, I wasn't thinking. Oh, boy. It's a legumentine today. Do you, want my beans?
He saw.
A change comes over him.
Black bean, Donna.
What's going on?
Get out. This is my body. I won't let you use it as you please. These beans are evil. As above the blue sky.
They look like normal black beans to me.
Indeed, have no fear. I shall destroy them now.
He opens the package and dumps its contents into his beak. Destroyed, indeed. Are you okay? How do I, I'm like a pigeon. Are you a pigeon? I don't know.
Don't worry about me. Skip what he can out of below.
Maybe he's a little young for black beans.
That's what it told me to get him, but okay.
Second year is almost over. Along here, I've got involved with a Filipino, a banana man, an eccentric fallen angel. There's a letter in my desk. Time has come. Meet Rufa, a tree of blight, crimson angel, Judica. He's from the eccentric Filipino, banana man. Interesting. Is he planning to break into the infirmary? The doctor being what he is, I'm worried for Angel. I better hurry. an actual tree. Did I go into the wrong room?
No, I'm sure this is the infirmary.
But this place is nothing like a... Looks like nothing like should I belong in a school.
It is time to end this dark saucer, Wallenstein.
I have waited for you, Crimson Angel Jutica. Waited from the very beginning. A tree obliged to have fed on the flesh and blood of the innocents and has opened the gate to the dark shell. We shall stand at the very portal between this world and the next. And so you have appeared, lured here by the dangers they are leaking through, just as planned.
So your plan has been to swallow the school into the abyss all along. Too bad, I shall not allow the tree to reach maturity.
Please, do not misunderstand. I have no intention of bringing the end with this wooden toy. No. What I want is your cursed flesh, Angel of Hell. I am Wallenstein.
I must agree that this is a fitting name for the Dark King.
Indeed, it is the best name for a Dark King. Yes, it is the most frightening, evil name I've ever heard.
Come to me, spirits of evil.
Hey, Black miasma flooded from his chest and swallowed by the tree.
What are you doing, Doctor? This is cruel. You should know reincarnation, Nito Blau, the apostle who sealed the Crimson Angel Judica. This dove holds within him an avatar of destruction.
An avatar of destruction?
Have you forgotten, Nito Blau? That day long ago in the time of gods and demons, when you took up the sword to end my rampage.
Oh no, sorry, I did the wrong one.
My bad. I have drawn out the power you sealed in his breast with the forbidden Mantrayana. The tree of blight has consumed both the students of the school and the mindless power of the Crimson Devil.
Merkham.
The end. I is amnesia, bringer of death.
I have no idea what this is a reference to.
No, it's over. The world would be swallowed by darkness. You can't give up, Angel. So, Blau, have you forgotten, Banana Man? I still have that ID card with the weird squiggles you drew. We still have hope. All we have to do is kill this final boss thinking, right? We stand together, Angel.
I never thought the day would come.
When do you...
I never thought the day would come. When we two would join in battle once more, I had not the courage to face down my evil half. But you, take this, Edel Blau. This is the mapping pen. Say, holy spear is yours to wield. Come. Amnesia, bring your death appeared.
Oh, I have wisdom. Oh, my stats are here. Vitality, charisma. Ankel uses a dark void shockwave. Now she takes 24 damage. Swallow's turn. Okay.
There's an order to that one's here. Okay.
Eye of Judgment.
Woo! Swallow uses Eye of Judgment.
Now she takes 360 damage. Apparently, I'm much stronger for some reason.
Amnesia unleashes obliteration blade.
So all it takes 215 damage. Oh, that came out of my vitality. Okay. And go use the bloodless cremation. Amnesia takes 68 damage. Swallow's turn.
Nochinki Shum.
Swallow uses the move, takes damage, damn. Uses obliteration blade, 240 damage. Oh no! Swallow's turn.
And this should be the last one.
Blauhemen. Flight? Okay. Is this just like supposed to
Is this referencing something specific, or... I don't know.
No, Imagia was destroyed.
You miscalculated, Wallenstein.
You did not account for Edelblau's presence here.
Ah, I must withdraw. Not forget. Shall summon second Imagia and a third until the war is torn apart by the thirst for blood.
Wait, Wallenstein.
So our adventure ended as suddenly as it began. Never saw the doctor at the school again.
Angel, I've remembered everything. I remember your fall, and I remember chasing after you to try to bring you back,
and you remember skewering me with the Sakuraman imprisoning me in the cage of ice?
Yes. I do not resent you. I lost myself. It was but a demon of blood destroying all in my path.
But the demon's gone now, right?
Yes. I think you can live normally now, Angel.
No, Banana Man. I hope we can stay together like this, Banana Man.
Ah.
Hiddle's in the corner, wailing in anguish.
I guess that rule is still in effect. I wonder when he'll let me use his real name.
Okay. These are mildly interesting. But it's really hard to say that they're anything more than mildly interesting. Yeah. The end of emptiness. Okay.
Did I get a thing for that?
I think I probably got a thing for that. I usually get a thing for that.
Yo, number one. At least you're supposed to have one more ending.
Loosen the identity report. We establish one of the students' number, 60781 special characteristic. He acts as a neurotransmitter, producing a trance-like state in bystanders. The effect is similar to that of narcotic. We will continue our observation. Ooh, do, 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 do. That could mean something. Ryota, maybe? I have been with Ryota for a while. Okay, so this one is... the BBL ending, Bad Boys Love, is all it describes it as. And I actually have to start a new game, which is different because I've actually just been loading up a save file I had at the first choice. Okay, here we go. It says all I have to do is select this to fulfill a promise. And it says, in the HD version, I can't fail. Is there anything you desire? I can grant whatever wish you wish, tell me. Strange bird once said that. Who was that bird talking to? And this is supposed to be the last thing, according to this guide. So. I hope this is the ending thing. The thing that's supposed to answer everything. Or have the big, like, surprising or... I get a feeling there's supposed to be a plot twist that comes at the end that is really surprising and interesting and makes it all worth it. Okay, we actually, okay, we actually got something new. I've been having these weird dreams lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not? Wait, no, wrong game. I've had this dream a lot recently. I can see a little house on the other side of the fence. I wonder who lives there. I don't think it's anyone I know. House. Wait, there's a fence? We live in a cave. Ryota is next to me, and my parents are here too. We're all together again, but... Mom? Dad? Hey, wake up, please. Okay, here's a new one. That dream again. Ryota, my parents, and me at a stranger's house. Ryota, my parents, and me. So... Okay. A strange bird who comes to me is a magician. He says he'll grant any wish that Ryota and I make. Well, maybe not today. Maybe not tomorrow. But one day. That's... Magician. Is it...
Is it the people from all the research stuff? That's my best guess.
Which brings us to my main topic, the observation reports on the human representative at St. Pigeon Nations. As you can see, while she was on the Hawk Party cannot overlook the situation. They will confirm we are extermination. Okay, apparently I can fail this. Fucking hell. Well, at least I made a save.
Ah. Guess it's just the Steam version.
I did purposely go out of my way to not pick anything that would direct me towards a single person's path. I didn't think it would matter, but just how I was making choices.
So I found another one that has choices I can make. God, this fucking better actually work.
Woo, I made it the second term. I'm not dead yet, Ryota isn't at his desk. He's always so slow, but I don't think he packed up and went home. Okay. Okay, so what I did was, according to the guide, it said, quote-unquote, story-wise, it makes more sense to do with do the Ryota route. Went home. Is this his, sir, wait. Hello, Kenya, what is it? You know where Ryota went? I don't remember this. I don't think I've seen him since homeroom. Went to the infirmary. Oh, maybe this actually doesn't sound. This actually sounds familiar. I'm late. Oh, this seems hurtful. Oh, okay, that's different down there. I've been slow getting out before, but I've never slept through my alarm like this. Hurtful. Maybe I'm not getting enough sleep, but anyway, gotta go fast. Sorry, I'm late. Good morning, Kawawa. We were just about to sit down. Kawawa. Inspector of a feral. What is this thing down here? No, no. Sir, where's Swallow? Isn't she here? Okay, they're not showing Ryota anymore. Apparently not. No wonder her kind died off. Ouch. Are you, Swallow? Oh, am I doing this from Ryota's perspective? That's why I'm not seeing him. Usually you'd be here early. You were late yesterday and all this. I think we can start homeroom now. Today we'll do a little review of the history of birdkind. You wait to teach that? You wait until now to teach that? What a pathetic country. Oh boy. Of course, everyone learned it years ago, but it's required for the second day of the semester. How convenient. Because Swallow's not here? Back when we birds were still beasts and pets, a virus known as AH5N1 appeared. At first, it only infected birds, but it underwent a mutation and spread to humans. Okay, I think I said something like that. This mutated strain was highly infectious and had an extremely high mortality rate. It became clear that it posed a threat to the survival of the human species. So the humans engineered a powerful virus to cull birds and prevent AH5N1 from becoming a pandemic. In hindsight, it seemed foolhardy and rash, but the world leaders of the time saw no better option. Except the new virus didn't work. Infected birds did not die. Rather, their brains grew in size and power, starting with doves. That's why doves make up the majority of the professionally qualified workers today. Other birds, including quails like me, are still adapting to social life. Incidentally, I heard that the first puffin in history to hold a governorship was elected last month. Even kakapos, which were once close to extinction, can now be toilet trained. And as you all know, the Prime Minister of Japan is a shoebill. I don't care. This is not the part I care about. Anyway, the development of social intelligence in birds had a huge impact on the predators. Which leads me to my next point. Since their gambit failed, humans were left defenseless to AH5N1. Most died out. The few that are left now live peacefully with birds, though in the past there were large conflicts. Ah, that's a bell.
We'll vote on student council members in the second period, so be on time. Wait, you're voting for that? What the fuck? Spala never came. I hope she's okay. Maybe I should try calling her. Kawara, do you have a minute? Sure. We're supposed to get our print boxes today. Would you mind picking ours up? Our print box. Yep, it has all the handouts and everything, since we don't have a council yet. Okay, it's in the faculty room, right? That's right. If you could have it back here before second period, please. Print box, print box. Inside the faculty office is a stack of cardboard boxes. These must be the ones. This one, maybe. I picked up the box marks 2-3. It's awfully heavy. I guess paper isn't exactly light when there's this much of it. Okay, thank you. Were you okay by yourself? It was heavier than I expected, but I was fine. Let's take a look inside then, just to make sure everything's there. Did you cut your wing, Kawara? Cut my... I don't think so. It's bleeding. Oh no. It is. Did I scratch myself on something? It doesn't hurt at all. No, this isn't my blood. What is that? There's blood leaking through a corner of the box. Oh no, is this why Swallow's not here? Oh no, is this the ending? Oh, this is the ending where Iwamine kills me. I feel sick. But I reach out and open the lid anyways. Inside the box is a human head. Eyes are glassy. But even like this, I still recognize her. She wasn't late. She was here all along. Oh, this can't be.